The new firmware 7.2 adds support of LeutTech's new LTE extension model, LTE 800. This interface connects to the USB port of a LeutTech device. All common cellular standards like LTE, UMTS and GSM can be used. It is approved for Europe, North America, Canada, China, South Korea, Russia and many other countries. A mobile tab has been added to the port configuration interface for configuring the LTE 800. The following example demonstrates how to enable this interface on the web UI. The values that you have to enter as the access point name, username and password can be found on your SIM card or on the homepage of your provider. On the web UI, you can also see if the LTE 800 is having a connection to the mobile network. New system registers provide mobile communication statistics such as byte transferred and SMS sent. This can be important using a SIM card with a limited data or SMS plan. A LeutTech device with a connected LTE 800 module can now be configured to operate as a NAT router. With this feature, it is possible to share the mobile internet connection with other devices on the LAN. The other devices need to configure the IP address of the NAT router device as their default gateway. LeutTech devices can now make use of a dynamic DNS service to register a public domain name. The user can select from a number of common DDNS services. With this functionality, devices are reachable by a domain name even if the public IP address is a dynamically assigned address. The new SMS template message type can be used to configure SMS transmissions similar to the configuration of email templates. The SMS can contain freely defined text and placeholders. To send the SMS out, a data point can be used as a trigger. One application is the SMS alarm delivery. SMS can be sent using the local attached LTE mobile interface. It is also possible to connect other LeutTech devices over the network. Therefore, only one LTE 800 is needed. With the introduction of the LEOP 110 and LEOP 590 models, a new LEOP I/O terminal hardware type has been introduced. A universally configurable in-out terminal. Within this signal type class, the known signal interpretation can be configured. In this example, we will configure the first I/O as an NTC 10K temperature input and the second one as a 0 to 10 volt analog output for the control of a heating valve. Keep in mind that on a digital output, a pilot relay must be connected. LloydTech devices that support the scripting feature now also natively integrate the Node-RED runtime. The web interface provides a configuration menu to open the Node-RED editor. As a default, the runtime is not executing and needs to be enabled. Once enabled, the runtime automatically starts the configured flows. The user can access data points on the device using the pre-installed ReadDB and WriteDB items. In this example, we will read out the system temperature of the device and send the data to the debug log. Therefore, we are using the items ReadDB and debug. The configuration of the ReadDB node requires all information to access a certain data point in the device. Additional node packages from the online Node-RED repository can be added to the palette. More information can be found on the LloydTech online campus. A new parameter value property has been introduced in the data point configuration. When uploading parameter values from the device into the configuration, the parameter value property is updated. The default value property remains unaffected. In this way, it is possible to store current parameter values while still keeping the original default values in the configuration. This firmware version enhances flexibility and control over which building automation protocol are directly available on the VPN. This effectively secures otherwise unsecured automation protocols such as BACnet IP, Modbus TCP or KNX NetIP. No unencrypted traffic will ever be transmitted. Each node establishes a secure channel on the OpenVPN server hub, which routes the traffic between the communicating peer nodes. The firmware now provides an option to automatically update the pre-installed LWeb 802 whenever a new version is available on the LloydTech website. New BACnet protocol features have been added to the LloydTech devices. First, dynamic object creation is now supported for trend logs, schedulers, calendars, and notification class objects. A BACnet OWS can dynamically create and delete those objects at runtime. Second, algorithmic reporting has been implemented in the event enrollment object. This object can be curated and configured by a BACnet OWS to dynamically add or remove alarm conditions on any BACnet object in the device. Last but not least, BugNet Loop server data points can now have alarm conditions. Also, some additional enhancements were implemented in the links add-in for LStudio 3. Parameters can now be uploaded from the device and stored in the resource configuration. Schedulers and calendar patterns can now be edited in the resource configurations and can be up and downloaded. And the links add-in now displays error messages in the LStudio Errors tab. These enhancements will also be explained on the LeuTech Online Campus.